might punch you guys in the nose. I might punch you in the nose.
Said he may punch me in the nose.
Those are our thoughts on the Pitt contest. You've heard Coach Paterno's thoughts. Now here's the action of the Penn State Pitt game. Penn State will defend the goal line to our left. Pitt will kick off and will have the benefit of a wind that is gusting up to 25 miles an hour. If you follow the temperature as it is at 25 degrees and with the wind that high, the wind chill has the actual temperature down to around zero. This game, for those few of you who do not know, will be played on artificial turf. The field was being swept clear of snow as recently as just a few minutes ago. Penn State will have Steve Geis and Booker Moore back to receive. Dave Trout, a freshman from Mount Pleasant, Pennsylvania, will kick off for Pitt. So this great rivalry, which started back in 1893, is about to be renewed. Geis at the nine. To the Penn State 23-yard line. The offensive line for Penn State will have Paul Renaud, John Dunn, Chuck Correll, Eric Cunningham. Keith Dorney will start. How long he can go remains to be seen. The tight end is Schuler on the right side. Fitzky and Cephalo are to the left. Fusina at quarterback. Sui and Geis the setbacks. Geis in motion. Matt Sui gets a yard before he ran into freshman Hugh Green, number 99, a Pitt defensive end from Natchez, Mississippi. The offensive backfield, Chuck Fusina, number 14, from McKees Rocks. State College's Matt Sui, number 32. Steve Geis from Lock Haven, number 29. Cephalo, number 44, wide to the right. Second and nine. Mickey Schuler, first down. Penn State 35-yard line, where the Panthers' Bob Jury made the tackle.
Chuck Fusina fades back here, looking to his right with their two wide receivers. Fakes the ball here, throws a short screen back to the tight end, Mickey Schuler. Comes to his left, stumbles, but makes the first down.
First down at the Penn State 35.
Everyone back yet?
Sui gets about two before he ran into linebacker Al Chesley, number 55, a junior from Washington, D.C. It'll be second down eight. One of the oldest rivalries in the nation between Pitt and Penn State. Penn State has won 37, Pitt 36. There have been three ties. Second down eight at the Penn State 37. Geis in motion. Sui loses five.
Here we have Penn State showing a new wrinkle into their offense, the option play. They have not shown this. Chuck comes down the line, pitches the ball out to Guy, to Sui. Good play here by number
Gary Silvestri.
Gary Silvestri, number 99.
For Penn State, third down, 13. Cephalo.
It's gonna go.
Jimmy Cephalo at the Pitt 20-yard line. Leroy Felder caught him.
Oh, let's look at this here. Twins receivers to the right side of the screen. Cephalo comes down on a deep post. Ficino shows he can throw the ball with the wind in his face. Fine reception. Jimmy spins off the tackle here. Looks like he's going to go all the way, but it's pursued from behind by Felder.
Bob Torrey at fullback, number 39. Torrey. First and goal at the five.
From the end zone. Ficino fakes the pass and comes back with a draw. Excellent call here. Beautiful block on Holloway. Torrey turns upfield like he should. Smells the goal line. Penn State's looking awfully sharp early in the game.
It is first and goal at the Pitt 5 1/2 yard line. Gets about a half a yard. Now, at the moment, Penn State has Guthrie, Geis, and Sui as the running backs, with Guthrie lining up as a flanker, actually.
Well, he's actually a wing back. He's a bigger boy, and he got him in there for the blocking, but it's very difficult to run against this Penn State, Pitt defense the way they're stacked here right now.
Double tight end, Schuler and LaPointe. Tried to hit Torrey, did Chuck Fusina, but Pitt defensed it very well. It'll be third and goal at the five.
Hey, that was a good call. They faked the off-tackle play, tried to slip Torrey out into the corner of the end zone.
Now Fitzke comes in, Cephalo comes in. LaPointe goes out, so just the one tight end now and the two wide receivers. Third and goal. Geis in motion. Fusina goes down in the grasp of Hugh Green, and Matt Barr will try to salvage something out of this drive.
Well, they put Geis in motion to the side of the two receivers to flood the area. Chuck sprints out to his left. Pelosi here, number 51, 99 Green, put pressure on him. He slips and falls down.
Kip Bernaglia will be the holder for a 34-yard field goal attempt by Barr. It has the distance. Penn State is on the board with Barr's 12th field goal of the year. It is 3-0 Penn State. We'll be back with first quarter action right after this. Penn State took the opening kickoff. Big gain in the drive on a pass over the middle to Cephalo on third and 13, which carried to the 20. Bob Torrey took it down to a first and goal. One running play gained practically nothing. A second down pass was incomplete on second and goal. A third down, what was probably going to be a pass, resulted in a big loss as Fusina lost his footing. And on fourth down, Matt Barr put Penn State on the board with a field goal of 34 yards. So Penn State leads by 3-0.
You know, Ray, we talked about it before the game that we thought the kicking, whoever had the better kicking game might win today in this cold weather.
Pitt will have JoJo Heath, number 36, and Gordon Jones, number 24, deep for Matt Barr's kick. 10:22 left to play, first quarter. We are told by the weatherman that we will probably have snow flurries throughout the afternoon. Penn State leads 3-0. 10:22 left to play, first quarter, as Barr kicks into a wind. JoJo Heath. 30-yard line. And now our first look of the day at the University of Pittsburgh offense. Penn State defensive line, Joe Lally, 84, Matt Millen, 60, Randy Sidler, 75, Bruce Clark, 54, Bill Banks, number 85. Pitt will have Matt Cavanaugh at quarterback, Elliot Walker, number 34, the one running back, Freddie Jacobs, number 44, the other running back. Elliot Walker gets 3 yards to the 32 before Randy Sidler hit him down. Penn State's linebackers are Tom DePasso, 95, Rick Donaldson, 92. At the corners, Neil Hutton, 26, Mike Gilman, number 24. The safety man is Gary Peter Kusky, number 42, and Ron Hostetler is the strong safety, or the rover back. Second down, 8, Pitt. Freddie Jacobs, 1 yard. He ran into Bill Banks. Pitt now will be faced with a third down and 6 at the Pitt 34-yard line, 33-yard line.
Here comes Cavanaugh down the line, hands off the ball to Jacobs. Now, Pitt runs the veer offense where they fake it, take it out, run the option off, and they can throw off. Let's see what happens.
Matt Cavanaugh, the senior from Youngstown, Ohio, one of the very best quarterbacks in the country. Third down, 7. Marker down. Gordon Jones was the intended receiver. Gary Peter Kusky was defending. Interference, Penn State. First down, Pitt at the Penn State 49-yard line.
Cavanaugh fakes a little bit of a play action here. He's looking for his receiver over the middle. Now, this is definite interference. Peter Kusky comes over the shoulder of the receiver before he gets a chance to receive the ball.
First down, Pitt at the Penn State 49. Penn State is leading 3-0. 9:02 left to play, first quarter. Willie Taylor to the left, Gordon Jones to the right. On first down, he tried to hit Gordon Jones, or rather Freddie Jacobs, who came out of the backfield. Defending was Mike Gooman. Second down, 10.
Well, Ray, I look for Cavanaugh to challenge his Penn State secondary, which we know is a little bit suspect right now.
Pitt's tight end is Steve Gostad, number 82. He's on the left side. He is a good one. Second down, 10. Freddie Jacobs. Jacobs gets about 3 yards, where it will be third and 7 as Matt Millen, number 60, made a good play. We want to remind you that announcers on this telecast are contracted and paid for by Total Communication Systems. Any rebroadcast, reproduction, or other use of the accounts of this game without the express written consent of Total Communication Systems is prohibited. Pitt has a 3rd and 7 at the Penn State 46. Taylor to the right, Gordon Jones to the left.
It's Paul's performance!
Got me go!
3rd and 7.
Let's.
First down to Gostad at the Penn State 35 as Penn State blitzed and got burned.
Well, here comes a blitz here, Ray. Kavanaugh straight back. They're looking for the tight end Gostad over the little hole over the middle. The back picks up the blitzing linebacker. He's touching for first down. It's a big play for Pitt.
So Pitt has a good drive underway. First down at the Penn State 35. Taylor to the right again. Jones to the left. Jacobs, the first man through, gets 3 yards. It'll be 2nd and 7, and Randy Sidler, number 75, made the tackle.
Ray, the way that Penn State's secondary is playing, the two wide receivers, they're double covering both of them right now, and that means the tight end Gostad could be open.
Gain of 2, 2nd down 8, Penn State 33, 7:26 left to play, first quarter, Penn State leading 3-0. Jones to the right, Willie Taylor to the left. Freddie Jacobs is caught for a loss as Ron Hostetler and Rick Donaldson made an outstanding defensive play.
Well, this is a picture book way of defending the option. He faced a handoff to Walker. Kavanaugh comes down the line. He's being pressured here by defensive end. He pitches the ball out to Jacobs. Let's watch. Here comes Donaldson and Hostetler up for the tackle.
3rd and 10. Taylor to the wide side. Jones to the short side. Walker is down. And Bruce Clark gets to Kavanaugh, but a penalty flag is down at the line of scrimmage.
I think it's against Pitt, but Ray, remember we talked about at the beginning of the show, before the start of the show, that 3rd and 10, Kavanaugh straight back. Gostad hooks over the middle. And they put Jacobs into the flat right here. He gets good pressure from Clark. Now, if Penn State can put pressure on Kavanaugh without blitzing the linebackers, they got a good chance of holding up in the secondary.
Pitt was guilty of an illegal shift. The penalty is declined. It is 4th and 20. Joe Gasparovic, a freshman from Harrisburg, who has averaged 42 yards per punt with a following wind, is punting to Jimmy Cephalo.
Let's get a chance.
Good punt, fair catch, Cephalo. It is dead at the Penn State 7-yard line. A fine punt by Gasparovic. And Penn State tried to block that one, George.
Yes, they came, right? They came.
With the score, Penn State 3, Pitt nothing. We'll be back with first quarter action right after this. After Penn State took the opening kickoff and moved the ball well to a 1st and goal at the Penn State 5, 2 plays later, it is 3rd and goal.
Heater Bowl tickets are now on sale at the Penn Fieldhouse. Call these two at your manager's location. All tickets are $10.
After Penn State took the opening kickoff and moved the ball very well to a 1st and goal at the Pitt 5-yard line, 2 plays later, it is 3rd and goal.
Pitt football ticket office. Box 7-4.
On Pitt's first possession, the Matt Kavanaugh-led Panthers moved the ball well until outstanding plays were made by Penn State's defense, forcing a 4th and 20 situation. Joe Gasparovic punted the ball dead at the Penn State 7. Torrey and Geis, the setbacks from the Penn State 7-yard line. Scott Fitzke was not able to control the ball inbounds, and I couldn't believe how much time Fusina had.
Well, they're deep in their end zone. Pitt's not expecting a pass. They faked the ball to Torrey here. Now, it looked like he had Cephalo deep for a second, but wisely Fusina doesn't want to take a chance. Deep in his own territory. He has all day. Tries to get Fitzke coming back now on an out pattern, but overthrows him.
Now it is second and 10. Matt Sui at fullback. Steve Geis gets at the most a yard before Hugh Green, number 99, made the play for Pitt. Pitt's front men are Hugh Green, Bob Gruber, Jerry Boyarski, Gary Silvestri, and Dave DeCiccio. The linebackers are Al Chesney and Jeff Falusi. The cornerbacks are Leroy Felder and J.C. Wilson. Jeff Delaney is the strong safety. Bob Jury is the free safety. It is third and 10. Short of a first down is Steve Geis. It is going to be fourth down.
Another new formation. They take Mickey Schuler, split him out, put Geis in the slot. Messina rolls to his right. He's looking for Geis on the sideline. Stevie might have taken it up a little deeper for the first down. They're short.
So Scott Fitzke will be punting. Gordon Jones is deep for Pitt. Jones at his own 43.
Great kick.
Back at his 35.
Uh-oh.
Midfield. All the way to the Pitt 22-yard line. Gordon Jones. So Pitt is in a great position now.
Let's Jones here. Coming out to his left. Now the Penn State defenders get caught inside. Watch the wall of block is set up. Here he comes, got the ball loose in his hand, takes it back for a big play for Pitt.
So Pitt has a first and 10 at the Penn State 21-yard line. Penalty flag down. Pitt was in motion. Pitt had a man in motion, I believe.
The split receiver. I believe Jones was in motion.
Pitt is going to substitute at wide receiver Jerry Rudersham, rather Randy Rudersham, number 19, from Mahwah, New Jersey, is coming into the game. Here's a signal from our referee, Gray Bauer. The umpire is Larry Ellis. The linesman, Dick Farina, the line judge, Earl Birdie, the field judge, Joe Dorenzo, the back judge, Paul Bates, and the clock operator is Tom Thamer. It is first and 15 for Pitt at the Penn State 26-yard line. Taylor to the right, Rudersham to the left. Wanted to hit his tight end Gostad. He was in that general area. Willie Taylor went deep. At any rate, it is going to be second and 15. Coming up at halftime, we'll flash back into the past and take a look at one of the outstanding players who has been a part of the winning tradition of Penn State football. This week, All-American and Heisman Trophy winner, John Cappelletti. Taylor right, Gordon Jones left, second and 15. Gordon Jones at the 5-yard line, first and goal Pitt.
This is a beautifully executed play. Kavanaugh fakes the option here, it's passed all the way, lets Jones come up the sideline. Lays it right in there between the halfback and the safety. Pitt's in scoring position.
So Pitt is first and goal at the Penn State 5-yard line. Oh, Jacobs. The Pitt offensive line as we watch the run again.
Good charge by the right side of their line. Here comes Jacobs. He breaks it back a little bit over the center. Finds a nice seam in there. Takes it down to about the 6-inch line.
Second and goal.
Fisher's calling touchdown, Ray.
Now the touchdown is signaled. Kavanaugh scores and Pitt takes the lead.
Here we have Matt right here from the end zone. Leaps right over. A good effort by the Penn State defense, but he only needed about 6 inches. He got in there.
So now for Pitt. Sophomore Mark Schubert of Springdale. With Tom Usick holding, will try for point number 7. Pitt leads Penn State 7-3. We'll be back with first quarter action right after this. Penn State held Pitt on Pitt's first possession, forced a punt. But then, Penn State was held deep in Penn State territory, and Penn State had to kick the ball away to the Panthers. Leading Penn State 7-3. 4:17 left to play first quarter. Dave Trout comes to the ball. Bob Torrey, the short man, to the Penn State 33-yard line. I don't know whether that was deliberate or not.
No, sir. You know what happened, Ray? The ball was thrown off the tee just as he went to hit it, and he hit it on the top. I've never seen that before.
So Penn State will have pretty good position now at the Penn State 34-yard line. Sui at fullback. Geis will be the tailback. Cephalo to the right. Fitzy to the left. Steve Geis to the 35. Cornerback Leroy Felder made the stop.
Hey, Coach Sherrill said he wasn't going to put in anything different in, and he hasn't. He's playing his basic 5-2 defense, and they play it very tough.
Penn State is sending in the plays by alternating John Dunn and Marty Sirosinski at guard. Second down, 8. Ruled to have been out of bounds. Cephalo is appealing to one of the other officials.
Here's a play action now. He's looking for Cephalo. Let's take a look now, see if he went out of bounds. Takes it up in the air. Well, official watch, it looked like he was in, but there's a flag on the play.
Let's see what we have. It is a 15-yard against Penn State. Ineligible player downfield. So it is going to be a second down and about 24. So Penn State deep in a hole now.
Well, Pitt was undecided whether to have it 3rd and 8th or 2nd and 24. Let's see what happens.
Suey, penalty marker down. Penalty marker down, illegal motion, Penn State.
Ray, I believe the right guard, Cunningham, was offside. They'll turn this down.
Some of the Pitt players would like to see it turned down.
Let's see if they call it on Geis. Yes, Geis's hand just went down as the ball snapped. You must be set for 1 second before the ball is snapped.
The penalty is declined. It is 3rd and 18. Irv Pankey is in now at a tackle, number 70. On the right side. Cephalo tried, rather, Fusina tried to hit Fitzke on the run, and it is going to be a 4th down. Let's see how Pitt plays this punt. The last time they set up the return on the left side and did it extremely well. At the Pitt 45, at the Pitt 38-yard line, 1st down, the Panthers. 3:06 left to play, 1st quarter. Pitt is leading 7-3 with the score set up on a fine punt return by Gordon Jones.
But so far, Ray, Penn State has controlled the Pitt running game quite well. It took a big play on the punt return and a couple of nice passes by Cavanaugh to get him to score.
Several penalties against Penn State were costly to the Nittany Lions, and Penn State had to punt to the Panthers. On 1st down, Cavanaugh. Gostad. Neil Hutton made the tackle, but Cavanaugh has found his tight end twice now.
Well, Ray, I mentioned before, the double covering the wide receivers. Gostad is one-on-one. He runs by the linebacker here, but Cavanaugh shows a beautiful touch. He lays it right over Donaldson, the linebacker. Almost takes it all away.
1st down, Pitt at the Penn State 27-yard line. Jones and Taylor to the right. Gostad on the left side. Elliot Walker was wide open, but Cavanaugh couldn't quite get it to him.
It has to be broken coverage. Somebody's responsible for the back swinging out of the backfield like that.
We told you that as a result of the wind and a 25-degree temperature, it is cold at Pitt Stadium today, and there is that Jimmy Cephalo or Chuck Fusina?
That's Chuck Fusina. Right. It looks like Pitt feels that they have to throw the ball and move it.
It is 2nd and 10 at the Penn State 27-yard line, and we have a timeout here at Pitt Stadium as Matt Cavanaugh comes over to talk with Jackie Sherrill and the other Pitt coaches. Yeah. If there's been one major weakness that Penn State has had consistently this season, it would have to be in pass defense, and it is showing up today.
Right, Ray. We talked about when they put Pete Harris in there for a while. Looked like it was tightening up. Then Pete broke his leg. You got to put another man in. They just haven't put it together in the secondary yet.
Second and 10 at the Penn State 27-yard line. 2 minutes, 30 seconds left to play, 1st quarter. Pitt is leading 7-3. Penn State has been hurt by the passing of Matt Cavanaugh. Taylor to the right. J. Jones to the left. Tight end Gostad is on the right side. Walker now in a slot left. Elliot Walker. First down at the 10-yard line. Neil Hutton made the tackle.
Kavanaugh calls an audible here. He reads the coverage, sees that he can hit Walker to the inside, throws a quick slanted. Now, there should be a linebacker to his inside, makes a nice run, cuts back again to his left, and again, almost takes it for a touchdown.
And right now, Pitt is doing just about what they want to do in the air.
Penn State's going to have to blitz a little bit, Ray.
Freddie Jacobs to the 1 yard line.
Right, here's the handoff. Now the Penn State defenders are sitting down looking for pass. They're not playing aggressive. Jacob sees it, breaks it over to his left, over the center, takes it down to about the 1 yard line.
So it is second down. Pitt conceivably could still get a first down. Second down, 2 feet away from a first down, a yard away from a touchdown.
That's a costly penalty.
Penn State will get a break here as Pitt's Elliot Walker was prematurely in motion.
That's the kind that hurt you, Ray. Let's take a look at Walker here. Watch him move. Way ahead of the starting count. And Pitt gets penalized 5 yards.
Second down at the 6 yard line. 1 minute, 11 seconds left to play first quarter. And since the opening drive by Penn State, Pitt has totally dominated the first period. Pitt was just penalized for illegal motion. Second down at the Penn State 6 yard line. Elliot Walker is caught for a loss to the 9.
Hey, absolutely a super play by Ron Hostetler. They come down the line, they fake that play. Off here to Jacobs, here comes the pitch to Walker now. It looks like he's got Hostetler beat. Ron refuses to give up, drags him down by the shirt.
Now, Pitt has a third down at the 9 yard line. Joe DeAnge, number 97, has checked in defensively at an end. Pitt now is bringing back their wide receiver, Jones. And Pitt has asked for a timeout with 31 seconds left to play in the first quarter as Matt Kavanaugh wants to talk with the coaches.
Well, this is an extremely crucial play, obviously, for both sides, but for Pitt. If Penn State can hold them here, and they only have to go for the 3, it'll give them a big lift. It looks like to me that they're going to have to throw the ball. Let's see what happens.
Eight at the Penn State 9 yard line. Kavanaugh looking. Intercepted by Hostetler. Touchback.
Big play.
Ron Hostetler intercepts, and Penn State takes over the football.
Ray, that's the first mistake I've seen Mr. Kavanaugh make. He's a school customer. He steps straight back. He cannot find a receiver. Looks to his right here. decides to go left, wants to run, and here he makes his first error of the ball game. Hostetler steps in front. That's a big play for Penn State.
That is only the fourth time this year that Kavanaugh has been intercepted. So Penn State takes over, first down at the Penn State 20-yard line with 23 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Torrey at fullback, Geis at tailback. Steve Geis. Neither team has been able to establish anything so far in the way of a running game.
Well, I look for Penn State to try to run the ball a little bit more to get something going on the ground.
The final seconds are ticking away here in the first quarter. There was no further scoring. The quarter ended with the score. Pitt 7, Penn State 3. We'll be back with second quarter action right after this. Second quarter action with Penn State in control of the football. We're back with second quarter action with Pitt in control of the football. State in possession of the football, forced deep in their own territory as a result of two penalties, had to kick the ball away to the Pitt Panthers. Start the second quarter, second down 8, Penn State at the Penn State 22-yard line. Hussina. He overshoots Fitzke, and it is going to be a third down and 8. Now, the wind is blowing from right to left. And I guess you could argue for a long while whether it's better to throw into a strong wind or with a strong wind behind you. In either event, it definitely hurts accuracy.
Well, yes, especially when it gusts. But that particular time, what they're doing, Pitt is playing bump and run, holding up the Penn State wide receivers on the line of scrimmage before they can get too deep. And Chuck is holding the ball back, waiting for them to get open.
Third and 8. In trying to hit Mickey Schuler with Jeff Delaney covering, incomplete again. Fourth down. And Pitt's doing a good job defensively.
The secondary looks awfully good. They've been playing, I said, some man underneath with two free safeties. And that time they had man-to-man Delaney on Shula, and he was with him as tight as a glove.
Gordon Jones is inside the Pitt 40 for Scott Fitzke's anticipated punt. Beautiful punt. Jones at his own 34. Fumbles the ball. Who has it? Pitt has it. Gordon Jones almost lost it back at the Pitt 33-yard line. Penn State unable to move the ball, punted to Pitt. Pitt has it first and 10 at the Pitt 33-yard line. Matt Kavanaugh at quarterback. Elliot Walker and Freddie Jacobs, the running backs. Willie Taylor and Gordon Jones, the wide receivers. Fumble!
Penn State's got it.
Penn State has it. Bill Banks recovers the fumble.
take a look at this. Looks like it's a bad exchange. Kavanaugh never has control. Ball pops out. Anybody's ball. Here comes Bill Banks. Over from your left. Gets the ball. And as Ray, as you said, as a soothsayer that you are, that Pitt has fumbled 55 times, and there's number 56.
Steve Geis. Geis gets a couple of yards to around the 30, but neither team has been able to gain any appreciable yardage on the ground. Geis got 2 yards that time. It is going to be a 2nd and 8.
Well, that's just a conventional sweep. They're trying to get around the corner. Dorney makes a block here. So does Shula, Dory, but there's too much pursuit from the inside, and Pelosi makes the tackle. Now, actually, what it is, it's two strong defensive lines playing against it.
Jeff Pelosi, a sophomore linebacker from Youngstown, Ohio, made the tackle. 2nd and 8.
There it is.
Fitzke. Fitzke is inside the 15.
Now, this is from the sideline. Look, a double wing formation. They fake a draw play to the fullback, Sui, and he comes across Fitzke over the middle. Now, that's the area to hit when they get into two wide, two free safeties, right dead over the middle.
First down, Penn State at the Pitt 13-yard line. Torrey, 2 yards to the 11. Freshman middle guard Jerry Boyarski made the tackle. Coming up at halftime, we'll have our regular series that we call The Paterno Way. This week, Coach Paterno will offer his opinions on a college playoff system to determine the national championship. That's The Paterno Way. Penn State with a 2nd and 8 at the Pitt 11-yard line, early second quarter. Pitt leading 7-3. Loss on the play, as Hugh Green made a fine defensive play on a pass to Bob Torrey.
Now, this is a fake to Torrey here. Now, looking to the left is Fusina, but he wants a screen back to the right. He's looking for Torrey over here. The line releases, but Pitt smells an excellent defensive play.
Now, third down, 11 at the Pitt 14-yard line. Cefalo comes left, Fitzke goes right.
A single cover Fitzke on this particular formation.
A penalty flag is down as Fusina is hit by Hugh Green behind the line. Offside, Penn State. So both teams have been guilty of mistakes in critical situations.
Right now, the play's just a bit sloppy here. Could be the cold weather. Breaks your concentration, but I hope not.
Penn State recovered a Pitt fumble at the Pitt 33. Moved to 1 first down on a pass to Fitzke. But then Pitt stiffened. And on 3rd down and 11, a pass was incomplete. Matt Barr will try for a 31-yard field goal out of a hold by Kip Bernaglia. It has the distance.
Good. That's a big play.
Barr is 2 for 2 in field goals. With the score now, Pitt 7, Penn State 6. We'll be back with second quarter action right after this.
Take a look at it here. Good hold, good foot, gets a lot of foot into that ball. We talked a little bit about before the game that kicking could be it, and that's all Penn State has going for them right now.
State's second field goal by Matt Barr brings Penn State to within a point as Pitt leads 7-6. And with 13:19 left to play in the first half, Matt Barr, with the following win, will be kicking to a duo of Gordon Jones and JoJo Heath, both extremely fast. Heath, number 36, Jones, number 24. Pitt Stadium sold out today, although I do believe some fans elected to stay home. Wind gusting up to 25 miles an hour. Representatives are here today from the Fiesta Bowl. Delighted, of course, to have Penn State. Representatives here from the Gator Bowl, talking things over with the Pitt officials as Pitt will play in the Gator Bowl. Penn State to kick off to Pitt, 13-19, left to play first half. Pitt is leading 7-6. Gordon Jones. Fine run back by North Versailles, Pennsylvania's Gordon Jones, before Larry Kubin, as he has so many times, made the tackle.
Jones tries to pick this one up, does a great job getting the ball this far upfield. He's an exceptionally dangerous runner. Good balance, good strength.
First down, Pitt, at the Pitt 28-yard line. Willie Taylor, wide left. Gordon Jones to the right. The penalty flag is down, and again, Gostad is open.
Well, they send the passer on a blitz here. And he's picked up by the faking back. This is Gostad coming across the field. And a deep pattern crossing gets hit here. Great concentration, excellent catch. Also, there was a flag on that, too.
The penalty was against Penn State. Pitt, of course, declines. First down, Pitt, at the Pitt 49-yard line. So Pitt's Matt Cavanaugh is having an outstanding day passing against what has so far been a porous Penn State pass defense.
Well, Gorsuch getting open, I said, because of the coverage, but when you throw him the ball, he catches it.
Gostad is on the left side, number 82. Here we go again. A screen to Freddie Jacobs. And close to another first down as Randy Sidler makes the tackle. But this is a good-looking Pitt passing attack.
Excellent passing strategy. Drops straight back, looks deep, and just dumps a little screen off here to Jacobs. He's watching, waiting for his lineman to get out in front of him. They got just a little too far. Sidler pulls him down from behind.
Gain of 9, second and 1 at the Penn State 42. Jacobs, no gain. Good play, Millen and Sidler. Loss on the play. Coming up at halftime.
Okay, this time Penn State guess is right. Watch the pass of 95. He's on a little stunt to the right. There was an audible there. It was a checkoff and a handoff. I guess it was to Jacobs. No gain. A couple yards lost the play.
Pittman has a second tight end in. Benji Pryor comes in. Third down and 2 at the Penn State 43.
Big play.
Great pressure by Ron Hostetler, and Cavanaugh is dropped for a huge loss of about 19 yards.
From the ground level, what they were doing here, they're faking the option to the right, but he wanted to hit his wide receiver to the top of the screen. See him take a look, but here comes the pressure on Hostetler on a delayed blitz, and he's playing a great game today.
Gasparovic to punt, Cephalo at his own 25. Pitt punted the ball dead to the Penn State 5-yard line after a long delay because of a general power failure here at Pitt Stadium. Penn State started to move on the passing arm mainly of Chuck Fusina. Penn State has moved to where it is a 3rd and 1 at the Pitt 48-yard line, but has lost the services of tight end Mickey Schuler, who is just now being taken from the field. After a Pitt punt rolled dead at the Penn State 5-yard line, the Nittany Lions have moved to a 3rd and 1 at the Pitt 48-yard line. 9 minutes, 18 seconds left to play in the first half, and Pitt leading by 7-6.
He got it in the back.
Penn State, 3rd and 1 at the Pitt 48-yard line. Oh, great play by Hugh Green, and Max Sui is dropped for a loss of a yard.
Well, Ray, this play is the first play that Shula's out. They run the ball right at the tight end. LaPointe misses block. Penn State gets stopped from making a first down.
So it is 4th down and Scott Fitzke to punt. Gordon Jones will be deep for Pitt. Now the clock did not move on that play, so we'll wait and see if the clock is operating again. At the Pitt 15.
Great kick. They got it. On the 1.
Inside the 1-yard line. And again, the clock is not operating, so we'll have to guess at how much time remains in the first half.
Hey, watch this ball bounce around. It is good coverage. Notice how the Penn State players got behind the ball, kept it from going in the end zone. And you know, Scott Fitzke has not kicked the ball for 3 days. He was bumped up a little bit, but he's having a phenomenal day punting today.
Pitt will have a double tight end offense with Benji Pryor joining Steve Gostad. The only wide receiver is Willie Taylor. Pitt from the Pitt 1-yard line. Elliott Walker gets a yard or so before he ran into Bruce Clark and Matt Millen, the two sophomore tackles.
Well, Penn State better be careful. They're in their goal line type of defense. They're playing man-to-man on those wide receivers. If he hits one of these boys on a dead run, he'll go all the way.
2nd down, 8. Freddie Jacobs to the 8-yard line, where it will be 3rd down and about 3. Sidler and DePasso make the tackle, but he almost broke that.
He looked for the cutback. He found some daylight. He's a fine runner.
Third down and about 4 at the Pitt 7.5. Willie Taylor, wide right. 2 tight ends.
Great play.
Fine play by cornerback Neil Hutton. And Pitt is forced into a punting situation.
Again, picture book defense. This is a counter option. He fakes the ball here to Walker. Comes down the line. Here's the pitch to Jacobs. Watch Hutton come up and lay it on him. Great play.
So Gasparovic punting from the end zone. Cephalo at the Pitt 42. Fair catch, Hutton at the Pitt 38-yard line. With the score, Pitt 7, Penn State 6. We'll be back with second quarter action right after this. Penn State, 1st down, Pitt 38-yard line. Steve Geis, 3 yards. And again, we will tell you, because the scoreboard clock is not operating, we can only estimate how much time is remaining in the first half. I would believe around 6.5 to 7 minutes, perhaps.
That's a good guess. Ray, that old fella momentum is starting to turn in Penn State's favor.
Geis picked up three. It is 2nd and 7 at the Pitt 35. Fitzky goes right. Cephalo comes left. Matsui.
Big hole.
All the way to the Pitt 19-yard line for a first down.
This is a super executed play. You've seen it come straight back. Here's a draw play to Sui. Now he breaks it over to the right, gets a fine block from the center. Correll sees the daylight, takes it upfield, running strong here. Beautiful play.
Sui came into the game as a leading Penn State runner with 612 yards. Fusina tried to hit Fitzky with cornerback J.C. Wilson covering. It will be 2nd and 10. Coming up at halftime, we'll show you a former Penn State football player who has attained success off the field as we open the Penn State yearbook. Penn State 2nd down 10 at the Pitt 19-yard line. The rival coaches. Across the way, Joe Paterno. On the near side, Jackie Sherrill. Sui gets it to the 16-yard line, and now a big decision with a 3rd and 7, whether to put the ball in the air or keep it on the ground.
Well, I think they'll throw for it and try to pick a type of a pattern that is safe, because they want that field goal to go ahead. But when they have Cephalo to the wide side of the field, a single covering Fitzky, and they're going to him, that ball was overthrown two plays ago, but he was open.
All right, 3rd and 7. Torrey checks in at fullback, number 39. Fitzky wide right, Cephalo to the wide side, the left. Intercepted by Pitt at the 1 yard line. It was intended for Fitzky, but a great play by the Panthers. Bob Jury.
They did go to Fitzky up the sideline. Fake the ball here to Torrey. Now, Fusina gets hit just as he throws it. Might have taken a little off the ball, but this is a similar interception that Jury made last year. He's a great defensive player.
Now, Pitt has the ball for the second time here in the second quarter, back at their own 1 yard line. Pitt with a single point lead, 7-6. Second quarter, late in the period. Kavanaugh run out of bounds at the 4 by Joe Lally, a gain of 3.
Well, if Penn State can keep them down here again, they're going to be in a good position to get some points on the board. Right now, they're controlling the Pitt running game.
I just wish somehow I could read that clock that is being kept by an official to know how much time is remaining here in the first half. Kavanaugh lost a jersey.
Well, Ray, you know, Kavanaugh is 6-for-10 for 112 yards. Fusina has thrown 16 times, completed 9 for 113, very even. But the interesting statistic is that Pitt has only picked up 14 yards running the ball.
With the score, Pitt 7, Penn State 6. We'll be back with second quarter action right after this. Defenses took over here in the second quarter, forcing punts by both teams. The defense has taken over. Both teams forced a punt. We pick up the action with Penn State in control of the football. Pitt has a second down, 7 at the Pitt 4-yard line.
Come on, Cooper! Come on, Cooper!
Freddie Jacobs gets it out to about the 8, and Pitt will have a third down, and between 3 and 4, Randy Sittler and Tom DePasso team up to make the stop.
Well, Ray, Penn State's jumping their defenses around to try to confuse Kavanaugh's audibles. So far, they're working. This is a very big play coming up for Pitt.
3rd and 3. Woo. Gordon Jones to the left, Willie Taylor to the right. Very close to a first down.
It's important where he marks that.
The ball is around the 11-yard line. And it is a first down.
Well, Kavanaugh did a great job getting rid of that ball. He really took a lick.
So Pitt gets a big first down just beyond the 11. Jackie Sherrill signaling. Jackie with the headsets on.
I see he put his jacket on.
Delay of game will cost Pitt 5 yards.
You know, Ray, our fans should notice the Penn State down lineman jumping from one slot to another, one man to another, trying to confuse Kavanaugh, and he's trying to audible and check out. That time he got caught for delay of the game.
Now, Pitt has asked for a timeout, and Matt Kavanaugh comes over to the sidelines. Joe Paterno is asking, how's come all the time allowed here?
Well, they didn't walk off the penalty yet.
The penalty flag was definitely dropped. I guess the flag was dropped inadvertently. At any rate, no penalty. Pitt apparently beat that flag by calling a timeout that one official did not hear. Elliot Walker run out of bounds after a short gain of about 5 yards by Neil Huck.
Pitt decides to fake the draw play here. Just throws a short out pattern to Walker. Doesn't get much yardage. Well played by Neil Huck. Right on.
We've been telling you how cold it is today. Chuck Fusina is electing to use a very basic method of keeping his hands warm. Gloves. Pitt, 2nd down. 5 at the Pitt 16. Fumble. Brown Hostetler hits Kavanaugh. There'll be a loss on the play, and Pitt will have a 3rd and 8.
You know, Ray, I think this time Kavanaugh's at fault. Looks like he pulls out a little too quick. Oh, no, no. He bumps into the dive faking man, loses control of the ball. He's bouncing around, picks it up, and he gets finished off by Donaldson.
But now it is 3rd and 8.
Hostetler.
Willie Taylor right, Gordon Jones to the left. Fine play by Mike Gooman on Freddie Jacobs. It'll be 4th down.
Well, you can't play this pattern any better than Mike Gooman just did. It's a straight back action. They run the receiver in and out, trying to get the yardage for the first down. Gooman closes very quickly here. Puts the hit on him right there, prevents the receiver from getting upfield. Great job.
Following the interception by Jury of a Fusina pass at the Pitt 1, Pitt moved to 1 first down, but now forced into a punting situation. Cephalo.
He's got
Gooman. Here comes Mike Gooman.
He's got to go in.
Touchdown.
What we have here is a reverse on a punt return. Now watch Seth Lowe hand the ball up to Gooman. Well, some nifty running by Gooman. Goes to the inside, picks up his blockers on the outside. Great inside move, great block, cuts back to the inside, and he's a great offensive football player as a defensive back. Beautiful.
So for the first time today, Penn State has the lead at 12-7. And apparently a timeout has been called. Some of the Pitt sideline people have gone onto the field.
They don't have a center in there. I don't think Penn State does not have it. Sidler in there. No. Yeah, Randy Sidler's on the sidelines, right? Oh, they're going for the two.
So leading 12-7, Penn State is going to go for a two-point conversion. And they want to have operating room and can and have requested the ball be placed at the hash mark on the left side of the field.
Well, they'll probably try some kind of a flood pattern and try to hit one in the back sneaking out. Let's see what they do.
Fitzky and Cephalo to the right. Cephalo came in motion.
Oh!
And Fusina had a hole and he lost his footing.
Ray, that was a well-designed play. Let's take a look at it. They have three receivers to one side, brings Cephalo in motion, and it's an option play which State doesn't use very often. Look at the hole. He slips and falls down.
So the lead remains at 5 points, and we'll keep telling you folks, we have to guess at how much time is remaining at any given time because the scoreboard clock is not in operation. JoJo Heath, Gordon Jones back for the kickoff from Matt Barr. You know, I recall one other game, George, that I was involved in, a telecast where we didn't know how much time remained. It was maybe one of the more dramatic and unusual situations I've ever known in football. That was back on January 2nd of 1956 in the Sugar Bowl game between Pitt and Georgia Tech. And the clock failed to operate after early in the first quarter, and we never knew from that point on how much time remained.
That's tough.
Out of bounds, and that'll cost Penn State 5 yards.
My problem is everybody tells me I don't know what time of day it is anyhow. So.
Obviously, Penn State's trying to keep the ball away from those two very speedy and dangerous deep return men, Gordon Jones and JoJo Heath.
Well, Ray, even though we don't know how much time is exactly left, I'm sure there's not too much time. They don't want to have a good run back and get Pitt to get downfield, get in position, get a field goal.
After a 5-yard penalty for a kickoff out of bounds, Barr kicks from the 35-yard line. Greg McCray is brought down by Gene Gladys of Penn State at the Pitt 34-yard line. Gordon Jones to the left, Willie Taylor to the right. Willie Taylor, Mike Gooman broke it down and almost intercepted. And that time, Penn State had double coverage on Willie Taylor.
A straight drop back. He's looking for Willie Taylor all the way on a deep post. He has plenty of time to throw. Gives it all he's got here. Here's a long pass. Now watch Gooman. He's running stride for stride with Taylor, but he closes to the inside beautifully. Gets his body between the ball and the receiver. Great play.
Second and 10 Pitt at the Pitt 34-yard line. Taylor goes to the left this time, and Gordon Jones to the right. Gostad brought down by Gooman, close to a first down at the Pitt 44.
Once again, Ray, I want to point out the reason why Gostad is getting open. Penn State is afraid of those fast wide receivers and the double covering them and putting a linebacker on Gostad man for man.
I would have to believe the officials have been keeping both benches informed as to how much time remains. Pitt was going to go that time without a huddle, so we must be in the last minute or so of the first half. But we're going to have a timeout here for a measurement for the down, as it, the gain was close to a 10-yard effort. First down. Taylor to the left, Gordon Jones to the near side. And Joe Lally brings down Kavanaugh for a loss of 9.
Hey, this is the type of a rush that a coach dreams of. Don't have to use your linebackers. You drop them off to close off the passing lanes, and here comes Lally from the outside.
No huddle. Second and 19. Kavanaugh stops the clock after, he'll get a couple of yards, and it's going to be a third and about 18.
Well, right, that time they defense Gostad the way you're supposed to. The linebacker knocked them down as he's coming off the line of scrimmage.
Ball at the Pitt 36-yard line with time running out in the first half.
Third down.
Freddie Jacobs. First down at the Penn State 37. Again, Pitt's going to try and go without a huddle.
Ray, they caught Penn State in a stunt. Sizzler stunted to his right and ran right by Jacobs. The perfect call.
Intercepted. Neil Hutton picks off the pass, and Kavanaugh has been intercepted again. It went off the fingers of Steve Gostad, the tight end.
That time they found Gostad over the middle. As I said, the wide receivers are double covered. The ball was there a little high, goes off his fingertips into Hutton's hand. And Penn State's secondary seems to have tightened up and is playing much better.
First down, Penn State at the Penn State 23. Cephalo. And the slippery artificial turf has taken its toll again.
Second quarter.
This is a slot counter play. Here's Cephalo following the pulling tackle, Irv Pankey and John Dunn. Looks like he's got a little running room, but he slips. And looks like he's going into second base.
Penn State asks for a timeout now. I wouldn't say the scoreboard clock is not operating, but it shows 20 minutes remaining in the quarter. So it's been an unusual and in some ways a rather bizarre afternoon with the power failure contributing to a lot of unusual happenings.
Ray, didn't you tell me this morning that there was a blacked out game here in high school? Maybe it has something to do with it.
Well, there was that happened when an automobile ran into a transformer, and they were trying to play the Class AAA, the big high school championship game for Western Pennsylvania. And the game was stopped late in the third quarter, and it's going to be finished tonight.
Maybe the same guy's in the car again, you know?
Second and 10, Penn State at the Penn State 22-yard line. Here goes Torrey. Short yardage. Out to the 26-yard line.
Well, I'm sure Joe is telling him to cover the ball. Let's not drop it. We'll be happy to go in with a present lead.
Third down. Seven. And that's the end of the first half. The score, Penn State 12, Pitt 7. We'll be back with a Penn State flashback, the paternal way, and the Penn State yearbook right after this. There was no further scoring, and the half ended with the score, Penn State 12, Pitt 7. We'll be back with a Penn State flashback, the paternal way, and the Penn State yearbook right after this.
I don't want to think.
Well, they're having some presentations here first.
Oh, I wish that heater would work.
Oh, jeez. Oh. You can tell when it went off.
Huh?
You can really tell when it went off.
Well, I know
it. Too bad.
Crowd noise just drives me crazy. Ugh. Hello, David. What's the story on Shuler? Do you know? Okay. Yeah, the reason David Baker. Dave Baker just came in. That's who I was asking. Oh, our heaters aren't working, Guido. I do not right now. Now I do, right there, yes. It's been brutal in the first half, Guido. Right now, yes, it just came up. Now it's off. Now it's off. Thank you. Oh, dear. Penn State will kick off to Pitt to start the second half as Penn State leads by a score of 12-7. It is getting, the wind has not diminished in any fashion. And the wind chill factor certainly has to be below zero right now.
I think it's gonna, both teams must concentrate on holding the ball. It's that cold right now.
We're back with the second half with Penn State in control of the football. We're back with the second half with Pitt in control of the football. Penn State will kick into the wind to Gordon Jones and JoJo Heath. Off the hand of Ray Jones and back over the end line. I beg your pardon, McCray, Greg McCray.
number six. So no run back, and Pitt will put the ball in play at the Pitt 20-yard line, first and 10. First and 10, Pitt at the Pitt 20-yard line. Matt Cavanaugh at quarterback. And the Pitt right tackle, Matt Carroll, or right guard, George Link, made a false move, 5-yard penalty, first and 15.
Ray, once the offensive player puts his hand down, he can't move. The Penn State tackle, that was Millen, jumped, and Carroll tried to move with him.
The second half kickoff went over the end line. Pitt from the 20-yard line, penalized 5 yards, illegal procedure. First and 15, Pitt at its own 15. Fine play by Bruce Clark as he hit Elliott Walker. Now, Elliott Walker came into this game needing only 93 yards for 1,000 for the season.
Well, he didn't get it on this play. It's a straight handoff. He's looking for the cutback, but Clark fills from the backside and really lays him down.
No gain. It is second and 15. Elliott Walker. And very close to a first down. Out to about the 28 or 9-yard line, where it will be third and one.
Okay, they fake to Walker, to Jacobs, pitches out to Walker. Hostetler almost gets him here. Gets caught a little bit from the backside. Bank chases him from behind.
Pitt has a third and one at the Pitt 29-yard line. And the scoreboard clock is working. Willie Taylor wide to the left. Walker gets a first down at the 31-yard line. Brought down by linebacker Rick Donaldson. First down, Pitt. Pitt's offense in the first half was almost exclusively in the air.
Ray, they only got 1 yard rushing in the first half, and it'd be interesting to see if they made any adjustments to open up their running game.
Same wide receivers, Gordon Jones and Willie Taylor. Down goes Cavanaugh. Joe Lowley finally finished him off. Great pressure from Bruce Clark, loss of 7.
Again, the great pressure from the down three, Sidler, Clark, Millen. They faked the dive play. Actually, they're looking at the top of their screen to Jones. He saw man-to-man coverage, wanted to get the ball deep. Cavanaugh scrambling around now, and Clark puts him down, Lally puts him down.
Now Pitt makes a change at wide receiver, and Randy Rudersham, number 19, will line up to the left in place of Willie Taylor. Second down, 17. Good play by Joe DeAnge. Many of the Pitt fans thought that the intended receiver was hit early.
It's perfectly legal. They're looking for Gorstead over the middle again. Now Penn State goes to a three deep, put in DeAnge in the middle. He's looking for the play. It's a free ball. Anybody can go for it.
Now Pitt has a third and 17. I don't know how warm that helmet is, but we've seen just about every kind of garb here today imaginable. Rudersham left, Gordon Jones right, third down, 17. The whistle blew just before the snap. Let's see what we have.
That's be too much time.
Five-yard penalty.
Ray, Penn State's jumping their defenses so much, it definitely has Pitt confused.
It is third down and 22. 12 minutes, 17 seconds left to play third quarter as Jackie Sherrill paces up and down the near sidelines.
You could see that screen pass to Jones again.
Hit Rudersham, it'll be fourth and 22, and the Penn State defense has stiffened. Now only Jimmy Cephalo is deep at the moment. In front of him, Hutton and Gooman.
Right, I think they'll run it back. They wouldn't risk roughing the kicker here. They got them deep down in their own territory. Here's the return.
Fair catch, Pitt 48-yard line. Good position for the Penn State offense. With the score, Penn State 12, Pitt 7. We'll be back with third quarter action right after this. Pitt took the opening kickoff of the second half, moved to one first down, but then by way of penalties and fine defensive play, were forced into a punting situation. And so Penn State has the football at the Pitt 48-yard line. That is our position here at Pitt Stadium, and yes, friends, it is cold. John Dunn, the Penn State guard, moved prematurely, and now it is Penn State guilty of a mistake, and it'll cost Penn State 5 yards.
Well, when he moves, there's no doubt about it. Much done, the left of your screen, fire right out on Holloway.
So first and 15 now with the ball at the Penn State 47. Cephalo left, Fitzke to the right. Ron LaPointe at the Pitt 43 for a gain of 10. Ron LaPointe playing in place of the injured Mickey Schuler.
And they fake the off tackle play right here to Geist, and they hit LaPointe coming right to left to the sidelines. Now, he just answered a question that was going through my mind. Will he hold up with Mickey Schuler out? But he makes a fine reception here. Good going.
Second down, 5. Sui to the 41. It is going to be a 3rd and 3. Boyarski and DeCiccio make the stop for Pitt.
Ray, this Boyarski, the freshman nose guard, is awfully tough. He's giving Chuck Correll all he can handle.
George Paterno is talking about number 68, Jerry Boyarski, the middle guard and Pitt's 5-man front. Penn State has a 3rd and 3 at the 41-yard line. Cephalo and Fitzke to the left. Geis in motion. Hit Torrey, it's going to be 4th down. So neither team has been able to establish anything here in the early moments of the third period. And Fitzke will be in to punt. Penn State leading 12-7, 11-13 to play, third quarter.
the right corner. Inside the 15-yard line at the 14. Pitt will have to start. Neither team has been able to move the ball in the third quarter. Each team has had possession one time. Each team has been forced to punt. Pitt has it at the Pitt 14-yard line as Matt Cavanaugh belatedly joins the huddle. On several occasions, Pitt has been called for delay of game. Rudersham to the right, Jones to the left.
Where's Jeff? Jeff over there.
Elliot Walker on a quick opener. And that time, Cavanaugh took advantage of the way Penn State had changed its
right,
defense.
Right, watch, Siddler jumps from the nose guard spot to over their guard. They pick it up, and here comes Walker with a big gaping hole. Clark tries to make the tackle here from behind.
Gain of 8 yards, second down two at the Pitt 22. Walker again, first down at the Pitt 24, I do believe, or close to it. Tom DePasso made the tackle.
All right, this is a very similar play. Penn State shifts, and they run the play right into him. The linebacker finishes him off right here, DePasso.
It is third and a foot. Gulman moves out with Rudersham to the right. First down at the Pitt 25. Jackie Sherrill, the Pitt coach, who took over when Johnny Majors moved on to Tennessee. The tight end, Gosnad, is lined up on the right side. He's had a big day. Walker, look out!
Uh-oh.
Peter Kusky makes a saving tackle at the Penn State 42.
Hustetler blitzes from the outside here, but they pick it up. Here comes Walker, he gets that little hole, breaks it out to the left here. The man who stops him is actually Hutton. Watch Hutton reverses around to the outside, forcing Walker back to the inside, and Peter Cussie can make the tackle.
First down Pitt at the Penn State 42. Lee Jacobs, and a good defensive play by Tom DePasso. No gain.
Well, Penn State's playing the option part of this series better than the handoff. Watch the pass will come over. He's got pitch man. He scrapes from the inside, makes a fine tackle. They're playing a guessing game right now.
8:45 to play, third quarter. Penn State leading 12-7. Pitt on the move. Second and 10. Penn State 42. Walker fumbles. Gains a yard. It is going to be third and 9. Hostetler pinned him down. Bruce Clark slowed him up.
Now they come to the outside. Here's the option. He pitches it out to Walker. The ball has a string on it. Comes up right back to him like a yo-yo. Donaldson gets a piece of him when he's pinned down.
Pitt has a third down and 9. Rudersham left. Jones right. Third and 9. Elliot Walker. Fourth down.
Well, Ray, he was wide open. That's what's known as flare control. The back reads the defensive linebacker. Now, if the defensive linebacker plugs, he'll block him. If he doesn't, he gets into the route. And that time, nobody picked Walker coming out of the backfield.
Now, Pitt's Joe Gasparovic has a chance to pin Penn State deep. Cephalo is standing at his 10.
Ah,
The officials are deciding if it is a touchback.
One said his momentum took him in, the other one says no. Does it?
It is going to come out to the 20-yard line.
Right here, it looked like we might have roughing the kicker. Here comes the hard rush. You're supposed to touch the ball. Gaspari puts a good little act on here. And Penn State gets the ball on the 20. They ruled that, Ray, that the offensive player's momentum took him into the end zone.
So as the snow flurries down, Penn State will have it at the Penn State 20. With the score, Penn State 12, Pitt 7. We'll be back with third quarter action right after this. Much offensively in the third quarter, the only exception, a fine run by Pitt's Elliott Walker. But it's been mainly a question of punting. And at the moment, following a Pitt punt, Penn State has it at the Penn State 20. And Coach Joe Paterno has to join our pom-pom girls and our cheerleaders today as being courageous in the face of this weather. Defense Penn State's running attack today. It'll be second down and 8 at the Penn State 22, and we have just passed the midway point of the third period. Cephalo and Fitzgerald are the two wide receivers. Torrey gets a yard. Linebacker Jeff Pelosi played it very well.
Well, they could have made a good sizable gain out of that. Let's take a look. Watch John Dunn, number 62, gets in Torrey's way here. He's trying to make a cut. Right here, he had a little bit of an alley there. Now John should continue to go upfield and block somebody.
Third down, 7, Sui at fullback. First down, 32-yard line. And I'll tell you something, you see, that took quite a shot.
What they did here, Ray, they run a double out. The tight end goes underneath to clear the linebacker. Cephalo goes deep enough just for the first down. The ball is very well thrown. It's a perfect strike. It catches the football and takes an awful lick here, I think by Felder or Wilson.
First down at the Penn State 32. 6:35 to play third quarter. Torrey. It is ruled incomplete, I believe.
Yes, well, he rules an incomplete pass, and Pitt blitzed on this. They pick up the blitz, and Torrey circles out of the backfield here, right here. Right over to the left, he just dumps it off. Now he doesn't have full control of the ball right here. That's what the official ruled anyhow. He goes down, loses the ball.
So second and 10 at the Penn State 32.
It's a blitz again.
Through the hands of Cephalo. It will be third and 10. I keep waiting for Penn State to make use of a screen to try and offset some of this blitzing.
Well, when Pitts goes into the blitz, they're playing man-to-man coverage, one-on-one on Cephalo and Fitzke, and that's tough. This just tells you how good Pitt's secondary is, an excellent secondary.
So a big third and 10 play coming up. Oh. intercepted by Leroy Felder at the Pitt 48-yard line.
Ray, I told you, they got a great secondary. Now watch this action here. Chuck sprints to his left. Now he breaks out of the contain here. How they put a lot of pressure on him. He throws, tries to hit the point. The ball's thrown a little behind him, and Felder makes the interception.
With a score, Penn State 12, Pitt 7. We'll be back with third quarter action right after this.